our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It's day 23 in Advent, day after tomorrow. We're hitting Christmas. I'd like to read again from the Gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 2, verse 11. They offered him gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Before we come to the gifts, I came across an institution named Infant Jesus. And being the Advent season, it got me thinking. And the more I thought about it, the more I thought, why do we dwell so much on Infant Jesus? Jesus is worshipped and adored because he did not remain an infant, because he grew up. He took the pain of the cross, he died for us, and that is why we remember Jesus, not because he remained an infant. And when we think of the wise men who brought gifts, they were not exactly bringing the kind of gifts you would bring when you are visiting a newborn baby. Let's say you are going for some child's baptism and you take a gift. It will normally be something that is associated with a child, the upbringing of a child, or something for the parents, or maybe a little money as such. But the gifts that the wise men brought for Jesus were not gifts that would seem practical at that point. Maybe the frankincense, because Joseph could have burnt it, and the stable, being a stable, must have been full of flies. He could have used it at that point of time, if you're looking at practical. But these gifts were not the kind of practical gifts that you would expect to be given to a parent in times of when he was looking after a child. These are gifts which point way beyond into who Jesus really is. The first gift is gold, which is normally given to royalty. The wise men acknowledged Jesus' kingship and said, "This is a king. This man is a king." They weren't bothered about the fact that they were kneeling in front of a stable. They knew that this was a king, his real worth. The second gift of frankincense is something that is offered in a spiritual manner. Frankincense is offered something that you offer to a deity, to a god. And that is what the wise men gave to Jesus. Even at the time of childbirth, even looking at the circumstances of his birth, they could see the deity. And that is what they offered to Jesus, frankincense. And the last gift of myrrh is something that is associated with death. This is something that you pack in when you are embalming a dead body. And that is the last gift that was bought, which points way beyond into the death of Jesus, the death and burial of Jesus. And the wise men, these gifts are so powerfully symbolic. They have been placed in the Gospel according to Saint Matthew to remind us who read the Bible that we should not remain with the infant Jesus or in the stable as such, but we should be looking ahead and worshipping God who died on the cross for us. When you hang your gifts on the tree, think about the ultimate gift that God hung on a tree. Let us pray. Gracious God, loving Savior, thank you for this day. And even as we are gearing up to meet Christmas morn, let us, O Lord, have you in our lives for who you really are and mean to us. Thank you, Lord, for the wonderful gifts that you give us, and help us to be worthy. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.